Sensible Camilla discovers Meghan's malicious plot after a Los Angeles trip. The nickname, That Minx, denounces all. Hello friends and welcome to the breaking royal news about the notorious hypocritical couple, Harry and Meghan Markle, on our Kate Middleton and the Queen News Version 2 channel. A royal writer claims that when Meghan Markle and Prince Harry relinquished their royal obligations in 2020, Queen Consort Camilla called her a derogatory term. Once the pair departed the United Kingdom to establish a home in Montecito, California, according to Tom Bauer, author of the 2022 book Revenge, Meghan, Harry and the Battle Between the Windsors, Camilla allegedly began referring to Meghan as That Minx. One commentator stated, "A brazen, flirty or scheming woman is referred to as a minx." Camilla calling the witch Little Minx is really quite tame and not cruel compared to the vile, vindictive name-calling about Camilla from Dimwit. I am sure there are a lot of people who could find better names for the witch, but of course, most would be deactivated on here. Another commentator said, "Minx isn't a cruel name for Meghan. It is rarely appropriate and in no way insulting. Meghan has been called much worse names since she wormed her way into the royal family by latching onto Dimwit Harry and using his highly unpleasant character to get what she wanted. Millions in the bank from simply being highly insulting of the British establishment. She was simply a third-rate actress being paid third-rate earnings and then she was raised to royal status. But Meghan does not have the ability to behave royally, which is her fault and no one else's. It is clear that Meghan fits the definition of a minx. Our Meghan is definitely a cunning and overly flirtatious girl. Look at any picture of her and Marcus, and most recently her with Serena Williams' husband. Serena better watch out when Meghan is around her husband. I think she may be on the way out from Harry and looking for a new male with lots and lots of money." According to reports, Camilla reassured King Charles that he had done the best he could as a father in response to allegations made about him. The Queen Consort is rumoured to be secretive about Meghan in general, but to have had misgivings about her ever since she began dating Harry. Tom Bauer declared, "Camilla had her doubts about the exploits from Los Angeles right away. She struggled to understand why Meghan would give up her profession and individuality in order to work quietly as a team player who was committed to the monarchy." Camilla sees Meghan's plan to hitch her wagon to hapless Harry in order to achieve her goal of global stardom. Only wish that Harry had Camilla's intuition. It would have saved him and his family from endless anguish. Harry could have married an appropriate, loving and supportive, non-attention-addicted woman, such as Catherine, and been a valuable contributing member of the royal family. It is a pity. The question is, why is Camilla so sensitive to Meghan? Does she hate this daughter-in-law? Very simple, because she has the sense God gave her a goose. Camilla is normal with an above-average IQ. She is a person who has the sense and experience to be alert and observant at least because of the positions in which she and Charles have been. Anyone with a working brain in the royal family has their antennas up concerning their own and family safety and those who use them and take advantage of them. Learning who they could trust has to be the first instinct to survive. Everyone in the royal family, except for Harry and Eugenie, was very suspicious of Meghan because of her not forthright behaviour. Do not think for one minute that the Queen did not have Meghan thoroughly investigated. And the immediate royal family, which, including the Queen, were Prince Philip, Charles and Camilla, William and Catherine, Anne and her husband, Edward and Sophie, Major Johnny and some very important security guards knew her profile right off the bat. You know others caught on quickly, either by observations or abusive diva actions, or recording and note-taking. Andrew recognized Meghan from seeing her in her working days on Epstein's yacht, but he could not say a thing without outing himself. We all know that Harry threw a hissy fit, and we now know by their own stupidity that the Markles used the threat of labeling the royals as being racist. Charles especially wanted Harry to be happy, so he tried his best to be welcoming. The Queen and Prince Philip just gave in and hoped for the best. But you've seen the looks caught by the camera from time to time about the Queen's true feelings. You know that Harry basically blackmailed the Queen into inviting Meghan to Christmas before the wedding, denied to Catherine, who was also engaged and has a 10-year relationship with William, and including her mother in everything. I believe this was the start of the decline of Elizabeth and Philip. Trouble, trouble, trouble with staff. Meghan's friends leaking to the media. Meghan's complaining, lying, and constant angry looks at Catherine when unguarded. Secrecy ruining everyone's activities. Although that minx might not appear attractive at first, the King also gave the Duchess of Sussex a somewhat more flattering moniker. Since she is hard and unyielding like tungsten, he supposedly called her tungsten. Do you think this is a compliment from King Charles to Meghan? One commentator said, Prince Charles's first wife was fragile. Unfortunately, this isn't a trait that works well as a royal. This was his way of indicating that Harry had chosen a woman who was up for the rigours of royal reality. Another observer said, tungsten is a hard, steel-grey metal of the transition series. It has a very high melting point. If Charles did in fact say that, it was probably intended as a compliment. It meant that he thinks Meghan is a very strong woman, capable of surviving adversities. I would consider that a compliment. Do you really think Charles would deliberately say something cruel to the bride of his own son? Granted, Charles was a little slow to grow up, but I do not think he would do that. I suspect he does care about Harry. He knows what he's been through and probably feels guilty about it. I think he wants Harry to be happy, which is what most fathers want for their children, even royals. The Mail on Sunday, according to a source, said that Harry needs a tungsten-type figure in his life since he can be a bit of a softie. And Prince Charles admires Meghan for her strength and the backbone she offers him. It has evolved into a phrase of affection. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex's plans to return to the United Kingdom to see King Charles III and Queen Camilla's coronation on May the 6th at Westminster Abbey are not yet known. According to a source close to the Sussexes, they have not yet made up their minds regarding Harry's potential participation, and neither the King nor Prince William has talked to him about it, according to the Mirror. It is known that Harry wants to meet with his father and brother in a formal setting before the occasion. A source reported that Harry has been quite clear about his attitude and hasn't changed it. He will not go if he thinks the atmosphere will be as nasty as it was for the Queen's death and the Platinum Jubilee. He has indicated he wants to make amends with his family, and the decision is up to them. But nothing has changed so far. Now, what do you think of the nickname Camilla gave Meghan after suspecting her malicious plots? Let us know what your thoughts are in the comments section below. We hope you have found this video helpful. Do not forget to leave a like, share, and subscribe to the channel if you are enjoying it. Now thank you for watching this newsletter. Goodbye and see you in the next videos.